ladies and gentlemen. Today's date is Thursday, April the 8th, and the local time in Denver is 10:44 p.m. So guys, right now I'm at the employee parking lot. I just parked the crash pad car. Guys, I'm here because I have a trip. So I started a 4-day block and I wasn't used on the first day. I just sat couch, and then while sitting couch, I bid it for this trip, and yep, here I am, guys. So it is a 3-day trip, and let me tell you about this trip. So number one, guys, I will be Kelly Rowland, okay? That is my position. So my first leg is going to be Denver to airport code MCO. We have a base out there. It is Orlando, Florida. I don't know if I've been here before. I don't know, guys. It sounds a little new. Okay, day two. Oh, I'm sorry. When I get to MCO, I have a 14-hour and 32-minute layover, okay? I'm sorry. So let's start there. Day two, MCO to ATL, shoddy. Y'all know that's Atlanta, Georgia. Now there, guys, in Atlanta, I have a layover of 14 hours and 9 minutes. And then day three, which is the longest day, is going to be Atlanta to LaGuardia, if I'm saying that right. LaGuardia to Atlanta. And then Atlanta to Denver. Okay? So the specs of this trip, guys, it looks like credit hours is going to be 13 hours and 41 minutes. Of course, this is my reserve, so it doesn't mean anything to me. Time away from base, 48 hours and 16 minutes. So guys, this is all about stacking up my coins. You guys can see by my paychecks, the per diem, it really comes through. That extra 100 to 200, guys, is something you don't see. And it comes in handy on that first check on the 5th, okay? But yeah, so my report time is 11:20. Yeah, this is what we are going to call a fake 3-day trip, guys, okay? Because I check in on the 8th at 11:20, but the flight departs 12:20 on the 9th. You see? And then I come back on the 10th. So again, this is a good trip for per diem. I got 2 layovers, and I'm just so excited, guys. It's all about making money and stacking my coins. Now this wig, this is a throwback wig, okay? I had this wig in my bag and I was like, why not wear it? I do have new wigs, but yeah, I like her. I got a lot of compliments because I've been wearing this wig lately and passengers love it. I wore a sitting couch, going to Walmart, people love it. So hey, I'm just gonna go ahead and rock this, guys. So yes, this is what I am wearing right now. I forgot the name of this wig, but I'll figure it out, guys, and put it in the video. But anyways, what I'm about to do is I stopped at Sonic, I got a cup of ice, and I meal prepped. Yes to the meal prep, I sure did. It's one of my favorites, no mystery, guys. But I'm going to go through, get to the terminal, go through security, check in, and guys, I will be with you when I am heading down that jet bridge, because this is a red eye to MCO. That's the first leg. So you guys stay tuned, and good evening, guys, from the parking lot in Denver. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is showtime. So I will see you when I get to Orlando. So you guys stay tuned. All right, ladies and gentlemen. So I finally made it to my room in Orlando. So let's do the room tour. So you walk in, here's the bathroom. And these are the toiletries right here. It's all about Neutrogena. All right, there are towels, a hair dryer. Here's the bathtub here. More towels. There's a mirror. Okay, then you walk out, guys, and then you see another full-length mirror, and again, I'm wearing the same outfit I told you guys about. Okay, then we slide here. Okay, you have the cot for your luggage, iron board, iron hangers, and that's it. All right, and this hotel actually has a bonus. It has a refrigerator, which is here, and they also have a microwave. So that is kudos to this hotel. This is for the coffee maker here. They have water there that is complimentary, ice. The sleeping area, I have a double bed and then another full length mirror, as you guys can see. Okay, there's the TV and the remote control. They have wrapped up, sterilized. Okay, a lamp, phone, clock. Here guys, this is where you will, you know, like a working station. You can charge your phone, laptop, order stuff from here. Little chill selection here. Okay, and ladies and gentlemen, this will conclude the room tour. Hi, ladies and gentlemen, and let's talk about the flight. The flight time from Denver to MCO was 3 hours and 3 minutes. Now guys, we were delayed, so we had a mechanical issue that delayed us by an hour. And we all know delays affect everybody. And actually, it affected my layover here. So originally, my layover was 14 hours and 32 minutes. Now guys, as of now, it is 13 hours and 31 minutes. So they shaved off some time. So it's really no time out here, guys, to do anything with an hour that we lost. But other than that, we were on an A321. You guys know this is my airline's largest aircraft. We were 3/4 full. I told you guys I meal prepped, okay? So I do want to show you guys what I meal prepped. Y'all know I love Sloppy Joe. Can we just talk about it? I really believe they need to bring Sloppy Joe back. Sloppy Joe needs to make a comeback like the Jerry Curl. You know, every once in a while, you know, you might see trends come back, like, for instance, finger waves, right? Everyone loves a good finger wave. Missy Elliott, she made it popular. You know, but there's certain styles from the 70s, the 90s, or 80s that people are bringing back. Bring back Sloppy Joe, y'all. Don't hate on the Sloppy Joe. Okay, guys, here's the Sloppy Joe here. Now, I did freeze it so it can stay cold, so it is still chill. Sloppy Joe on line one. And y'all know I love Ruffles, okay, with my Sloppy Joe, but I decided to try to be a little healthier, and I got green beans. All right, so I got 2 cans of green beans, no sodium added. Yeah, and you know what's so crazy? Oh, and buns, okay, for this 3-day. So if I run out of bread, I can just mix in the green beans with the Sloppy Joe. So yeah, I mean, I had a very adventurous day yesterday, guys. Got up early, went to breakfast. Then we went to Trader Joe's, okay? Trader Joe's was something else. I've never been. It is an experience, okay? After Trader Joe's, I went to Marshall's and got some walking shoes. Came back to the crash pad and I walked. So I'm trying to lose weight, and walking for me is easy. You know, just pace it out, take my time. So I walked, I think they did, what, 1.92 miles, almost 2 miles, which is not bad. But I walked, guys, listening to Earth, Wind and Fire's September and Les Groove. I mean, I was really walking, trying to pace myself. It was hot, I didn't have no wig on. Yeah, so my back hurts, my legs are burning, but it's a good burn. I need to start doing that and try to be healthy again. So that's what I did today. So I am a little tired. Now here's the catcher. Because we got in so early, our report time today going to Atlanta looks like it is 8:50. So we are taking an 8 p.m. shuttle. So yeah, day two, which is today, it's so odd that we're talking about this, but yeah, we have a layover, but we're leaving tonight. So it looks like it's not gonna be a long flight. MCO to Atlanta, it's blocked at an hour 40. So guys, right now the local time in Orlando, Florida is 7:54 a.m., guys, so. I got less than 12 hours. What I'm gonna do, guys, is put my Sloppy Joe and green beans in the refrigerator, and I'm gonna go downstairs and have breakfast. I'll take a picture for you guys, but with such a short stay, there's not much to do, guys. So I will be with you later when I am heading to my second layover, which is Atlanta. So yeah, you guys stay tuned on this Friday morning in Orlando. Here's my breakfast. So I got potatoes, scrambled eggs, bacon, toast, and cereal with milk and orange juice. Bon appetit. And good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Today's date is still Friday, April the 9th. Local time right now in Orlando is 7:47 p.m. 8 o'clock, van time. Guys, one leg, MCO to Atlanta. It's not blocked at, I think it's like an hour 40 minutes, but we might get there under that. Yeah, it looks like it's gonna be a full flight. It's always a full flight going or coming to Atlanta. So yes, that's what's going on. I slept very well. Just so happy, guys, to have this trip again. Look forward to my second layover. I have been to this hotel before. Beautiful hotel, so I'm just so excited, guys, for another 14-hour layover, which is weird because we came in this morning and leaving the same day. It just feels very weird to me that this is actually day two, or that this is actually the second pairing in the same day. Very weird, but that's what's going on. So, guys, I'm just going to go downstairs, meet my crew. I took a shower. My wig, I'm sure she slept beautiful because she's acting right now. It's just a beautiful day. You know, I'm very sad, guys. I woke up and I found out that DMX passed away and also Prince Phillips. But yeah, you know, I love DMX. I think there was a video I talked about his song that I love even to this day. What These Want From A. Y'all know the song? Love DMX. He was so real, guys. He was so transparent about his shortcomings, his demons, his sins, his prayers. I listened to a prayer he did on The Breakfast Club. It just resonated with me. You know, the Bible says no weapon formed against you should prosper. And DMX, he elaborated. He said the Bible never said a weapon wouldn't be formed. He said that the word never said that the person who attended to make the weapon would not try to harm you. What the Bible says is that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. So he spoke a lot of volume in that prayer. And I remember when Aaliyah passed away for her video, I Miss You, he prayed for her. Guys, he had a troubling life. We are all sinners. Nobody is perfect. We all have a past. He was transparent. He reminds me of my mother. You know, he had an addiction. And, you know, no matter what happened to him in the last days, you know, I hope he is resting in peace. I really, really do. And it bothered me. I did shed some tears because it's just funny how when a celebrity is, you know, in the hospital, the rumors, they fly, you know. I don't know, guys. But, yeah, I'm going to lift up his family in prayer because they did lose somebody. Regardless of how the world saw DMX or Earl Simmons, he was a father. He was about to get married. You know, he was a friend. He was a brother. He was a nephew to somebody. And I think we need to remember that. It's minus his celebrity. He was human like you and me. All right. So, guys, I'll see you at the airport when I'm going down to Jet Bridge. But, yeah, this is going to be the second pairing. Yeah, this is going to be the start of the, I want to say day two, but it's in the same day, so I don't know. But you guys stay with me, and I'll be with you later. All right, guys, we had a delay. So right now we are heading down the Jet Bridge to start this leg to Atlanta. A lot of stuff going on, but I'm just happy that you're about to take off. So guys, I'll be with you when I land in Atlanta. So stay tuned. All right, guys, so I finally arrived in Atlanta. So let's do the room tour. All right, we're gonna start with the bathroom. So I love the wall. I love those colors. So these are the toiletries at this hotel here, and those glasses. There are towels, an amazing selfie light. There I am. Okay, the soap. I just washed my hands. Kleenex, more towels down here. There is a hair dryer. All right, here's the shower. We go out and then we hit the closet here. Okay, there's a iron board, hangers with a laundry bag. And guess what? Bam, that's right. There is another mirror. Then this one does have a refrigerator, which is right here. Oh, wow, coffee maker. And I think there's the stuff for the coffee. Perfect. All right, ice,
another mirror.
Okay guys, and then we're going to the sleeping area. So you see I have a double bed. Again, these come with lights that you can put on, a personal light that's a little bright. You can sit here, full length mirror, okay? And then there is the TV, drawers. Okay, this hotel, I love these. I'm definitely gonna take this with me. You guys know there's a cleaning fee if you smoke. Okay, the remote control is in plastic. This is a work station area with a light, a chill section right here with a table. You know, you can lounge with a lamp and you can see what I'm talking about with this light here. So, see that? Has that little personal light. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and this will conclude the room tour. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and let's talk about the flight. So guys, we had a little of a delay with our flight. The delay was about, I wanna say 30 minutes, but we made up for it because we were blocked at an hour 40 from MCO to Atlanta, when in actuality, the flight was an hour and 2 minutes. So we did make up time. We were on an A320 Space Flex. So this is the aircraft that has 186 passengers max capacity, 31 rows of seats. So we were nearly a full flight, which is a good thing, guys. We're very grateful our flights are getting full. We will be very excited once service comes back. So guys, when I got to the hotel, I did get a chance to warm up my Sloppy Joe. And that is what I'm eating right now. You know, good old Sloppy Joe. And I am eating this with, I got some Gatorade from downstairs. I got my little glass of ice here. So yeah, it was a pleasant flight, a short flight. Tomorrow is gonna be brutal. Yeah, it's going to be Atlanta to LaGuardia. I don't know if I'm saying that word right. And then LaGuardia back to Atlanta, Atlanta to Denver. So we're going to see what happens, guys. It's always mixed butterflies with certain routes. You know, just things that I've heard. I did do this before when I picked up a trip out of Vegas, that double layover in Atlanta. So, but I'm still excited, you know, to be flying right now. Knowing everything that's going on, I'm just happy to still be working. And that's what it's all about. When you're not flying, you have a lot of downtime and, you know, you just reflect on a lot of things. So I got my sandwich. See, got that good Sloppy Joe here. And green beans. Green beans are nasty, but here's a trick. So guys, what I used to do is I would put green beans in my Sloppy Joe. So when I ran out of bread, that's what I did. Because honestly, eating these green beans by itself is disgusting, but adding Sloppy Joe to it, it's a remix. It's like a Sloppy Joe souffle, per se. So yeah, the local time right now in Atlanta is 1:03 a.m. So it is officially Saturday, April the 10th. Yeah, and I go back, and then I'm off on the 11th and the 12th. So I don't know what I'm gonna do. I might try to go home to Arizona, or I just might stay here. I'm not sure, but this is a potential base that I want to transfer to. I don't know, guys. It's still a little iffy for me. Going to decide what's the best decision for me. But this flight crew is awesome. No complaints, really, guys. I'm just happy that Crew Scheduling gave me this trip, because like I said, the competition is real. But guys, I'm just going to sit here and eat my Sloppy Joe and green beans. Probably search on the internet, look at DMX tributes and other videos, you know, about what's going on as of yesterday. Even about Prince Philip. So I've been fascinated with the Queen, and you know, my thing was Princess Diana. That was my girl. When she passed away, it really did affect me, because I remember the image of Prince Harry and Prince Williams walking behind her casket. And then I think there was like either a card or something that said mommy, but mommy was with a U and not an O, like how we say it. So that always, you know, tears me apart, because we are about the same age. I believe Prince Williams is my age, but yeah. So Princess Diana was my girl. Let me just say that. that was a shocker for me. But yeah, guys, we have a report time of 1:59 at the gate. We're gonna leave here at 1 o'clock and make it to the airport in time to, you know, give us a chance to get something to eat and get to our gate. So yeah, guys, if I'm doing something tomorrow morning, I will definitely, you know, let you know. But as it stands, guys, I'm gonna have myself a good night, eat this Sloppy Joe, and mind my business. So I will talk to you in about 12 hours. Yeah, just about 12 hours, so bye, guys. So good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today's date is Saturday, April the 10th. Local time right now in Atlanta, Georgia, is 12:47 p.m. Okay, guys, so me and my crew, we're gonna meet downstairs at 1 to head to the airport. And honestly, I didn't do anything last night. I did get a good night's rest, talk to my dad for a few hours, literally. And that's really about it. Ate my Sloppy Joe, those dry green beans that I had, and had water, Gatorade, and that's all I did. So here I am. This is day 3. This is the third day of my 3-day trip. So today, guys, it's going to be a little bit longer. It is Atlanta to LaGuardia, LaGuardia back to Atlanta, Atlanta to Denver. So that will be the end of my 3-day trip. Pretty good trip. Had a couple of bumps, but that's life. Things are not going to go perfect, and things are not going to go according to what you expected for things to go. So yeah, I always pray before I do my pairings. I ask God to, you know, order my steps and to be with me, help me to be patient, help me be kind, help me to be the Deann that He knows I'm able to be. Always ask, you know, God for prayer, because again, I don't know what can happen, guys. Anything can happen while I'm flying, you know, and I want all of us to get to our final destination safe. But right now, what I'm gonna do is get my bags together, pack up my Sloppy Joe, and head downstairs, guys. So more than likely, we're gonna be at the airport a little bit early. You'll see me when I go down that jet bridge. I'm going to attempt to possibly stop at Starbucks. May or may not. That line sometimes is real disrespectful, so that all depends. But anyways, it's a beautiful day on a Saturday. Guys, I will be with you later. So you guys stay tuned, and again, good afternoon.
Guys, we're headed down to jet bridge right now. We had a gate change because there was a flight that was delayed at our gate. So now we are delayed, but our first leg again is LaGuardia, if I'm saying that right. So guys, when I get there, I will be with you. This is the first pairing, so stay tuned. All right, guys, we are safely in LaGuardia. Right now the local time is 5:11 p.m. Okay, on the A320 Space Flex, so 186 passengers, max capacity, 31 rows of seats. We took this plane yesterday. The animal is not in the front, so I don't know what animal is on the tail, but it was a 1-hour, 40-minute flight. We're gonna go right back.
Do you need the vacuum for anything?
Yeah, just right here. Yeah, just a little, yeah,
that's it. All right, perfect, I'll have to do it.
Okay. Yeah, guys, so we're done cleaning. We're gonna head right back to Atlanta. That'd be my second leg, and then again Atlanta to Denver. So pretty pleasant flight. We were oversold by 1, but we were nearly full with the final count. So ladies and gentlemen, I will be with you shortly. I will see you back in Atlanta. Ladies and gentlemen, we made it to Atlanta. Some crazy things, medical, that we had to take care of, but we are here. It is 8:34 p.m. So we were supposed to arrive at 8:35, so we've been here for a while. We just had to wait for paramedics. All right, guys, so let me show you the view. It was raining when I left Atlanta. It looks like it's not no more. You can see it was a rainy night in Georgia. Now it's not. A little cloudy, but it's all good. It is all good. Flight time, it was 1:56 from LaGuardia back to Atlanta. I don't know if I'm saying that word right, but correct me if I'm wrong. I'm trying. It's just not familiar with me. So I got one more leg. This is going to be the longest leg of this day, and that is heading back to Denver. It's blocked at 3 hours and 33 minutes. We probably get there at 3 under 3 hours, I don't know. But we were nearly, so we were oversold when we were in LaGuardia coming here. And we have a few open seats, so that's a good thing. That's why I tell you guys, the number of tickets sold and checked in are always, always different. So right now we're just having a little ground time, and ground time is time between flights. This is basically a little short freestyle, okay? That kind of freestyle, okay? Not getting paid, but I'm happy everything worked out. My wig, oh my gosh, I took my wig off to kind of puff her out and fix her because she was backsliding like a sinner. And it looks like I dropped it in, I don't think it was water. So I had to wash my wig. Some of my wig is wet in the back. I think it was Mountain Dew-ish. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Okay, number one, I think that's where I dropped my wig in, so I'm very disappointed. But yeah, I had to wet her in the back and wash her with hand soap because, ugh, that just bothers me. Y'all don't understand, but it's my fault for taking my wig off while it was turbulent in the bathroom. Because when I went in there, it wasn't turbulent. And then, or I had her off and she kind of went backwards, so that's what happened. But anyways, y'all, we're going to be boarding in the next 5 minutes. I was able to eat my Sloppy Joe with green beans. It was cold, but I was starving, and I think I'm good to go. Again, one more leg, and then I will be done with this 3-day. So guys, I will be with you later. You guys stay tuned, but we got one more leg.